Hello everybody, hope you all are doing good. Today I will be introducing you some more sounds in English language. So children, as you are already aware of the phonics and also you are thorough with the vowel sound, it's time to introduce you with some new sounds. So today I will be talking about some new sounds and they are known as digraph. But don't get confused with the name. What you have to actually focus is on the sound, and you have to understand where and in which words these sounds are actually used. So what is a digraph? A digraph has two letters which makes one sound. So till now we have learned that every letter has a phonic sound, like B says B, C says K, L says L, M says M. So these are the phonic sounds of these letters. But in case of digraph, two different letters together will make one sound. So today I will be talking about consonant digraphs and the five most commonly used consonant digraphs are sh, which is S and H will give us sh sound. So when we want to say somebody to be quiet, what do we say? Sh, it's that sh sound. So S and H together will give us sh sound. So it is the very commonly used digraph, sh. And the next one is ch. So when C and H, what is the sound for C? It is k sound. And for H, it is h. But when we bring them together, and it gives us one sound, and that is the ch sound. Okay? So ch as in case of chicken, ch, ch sound. And the next sound is th. T and H together will give us th. What is this? This is a thumb. Yes. So the word thumb has the th sound in the beginning. So T and H together is giving us one sound, and which is known as the th sound. Next is the WH sound. Wah. What do we say? Wah. As in case of a whistle or where or what, okay? WH together will give us W sound. And next, the last consonant digraph to which we will be learning today is P and H, and which gives us the F sound. So children, these are the few commonly used digraphs, and today we will learn and we will see more words where these digraphs are used. Okay, so I will start one by one, and first I will start with the sh sound. As we said, the two letters will make one sound. So here, what all are the two letters? It is S and H, and it is giving us the sh sound. And in Hindi we can write it as sh. Okay, this is that sound, sh sound. So I have written SH with a different color so that the students, the beginners, they don't get confused. They read it as one sound, sh, ship. Okay, if I don't color code it, they might read it as s, h, e, p, which will be wrong, because till now they have learned the phonics. So they will read it as s, h, e, p. But here I have color coded it. You can also use different color at home while you are doing, or you can underline the sound so that it is very clear that it is one sound. Ship, then again sh, eep, sheep, sh, ark, shark, and here at the end we have the sh sound, fish and dish. So these are few words which have SH sound, the sh sound. Ship, sheep, shark, fish and dish. So the next sound is CH, which says ch. In Hindi we say ch. This is C and H together will give us the ch sound. So ch, app, chat, chip, chip. Or if we put s, it becomes chips, chin, chin. And at the end we have ch sound, march. This is the ch sound at the end. And in case of bench also, at the end we have this ch sound. So again I have used different color so that it becomes very simple for the students to understand that it is a different sound, it is ch sound, and they don't read it at individually as kh, h, at, because if they are reading phonics they might do that. So that's why you can underline it or use different color. And now we have another sound, that is t and h. It gives us th sound and also the sound. Sometimes it gives us th sound, th, and sometimes it gives us the sound. So we will see the words where it is giving th, like th ink, think, or thank, th ank, thank, think, thumb, th, thumb. So here we are using the th sound, and in few cases th gives us the sound, like this, that, there, the, those. In all these words the is, it's a th is giving the sound. So th and the. Okay. And the next digraph, it is W and H. WH together gives us wah sound. Wah. Okay. So you have to say it like this. Wah. As in case of what, when, WH. What, when, where, when. Okay. So here again, you can just underline WH so that it is very clear to the students. What, when, where, and whale. So W and H together is giving us the W sound. And the last digraph for today is PH, which gives us F, F, F sound. F sound, as in case of photo, phonics, or phone. So PH gives us F sound. So students, don't think about the name. You don't have to get confused with the name, because what is important is the sound. The sh sound, H is giving the sh sound. So just take a quick recap. Okay. So what all we learned today? The consonant digraphs. SH, sh, CNH, ch, TH, th, and sometimes the, and WH, wah, and the last one, P and H gives us f sound. So students, this is all for today. Keep practicing, and I will see you again with some other interesting topics. So till then, take care and bye-bye.